Regulation and significance of glycolysis. My name is Dr. Alamzev. I am a professor at the Department of Biochemistry, University of Malacca. First, we need to know what is a regulation. Biochemical regulation is the control of a biochemical pathway using enzyme inhibition. This may depend on activities of certain enzymes called regulatory enzymes. These regulatory enzymes are governed by allosteric inhibition, feedback inhibition, and reversible inhibition. In glycolysis, we have three enzymes which are regulatory enzymes, and they control the process of glycolysis. The first one is hexokinase, second one is phosphofructokinase, first in pyruvate kinase enzyme. Now we will discuss each and separately. Hexokinase, the first enzyme which convert glucose or any hexose into hexose monophosphate is usually inhibited by the product glucose 6-phosphate or inhibited by competition at the active site by allosteric inhibition at the separate enzyme site, while the second enzyme phosphofructokinase, this enzyme is the one in which also an ATP is consumed. It is an allosteric enzyme. It is made of 4 subunits. The activity of this enzyme is controlled by many activators and inhibitors. The last and important enzyme is pyruvate kinase. This is the enzyme which convert phosphoenol pyruvate to pyruvate. The enzyme is very important. There are 4 mammalian pyruvate kinase isoforms with unique tissue expression, patterns, and regulatory properties. This enzyme is inhibited by allosteric inhibition and intracellular signaling. So these 3 enzymes are those which control glycolysis. Significance of glycolysis. Why glycolysis is so important? This pathway is utilized by all the cell and tissues to get energy, which is stored in the form of ATP and NADH. It occurs in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. It is employed in both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. It occurs in the cytosol, so it is a very important process of energy generation for those organisms who do not possess mitochondria. The end product of glycolysis is pyruvate, which is an intermediate of various other processes such as gluconeogenesis, fatty acid synthesis, fermentation, etc. Even intermediates of the glycolysis processes are utilized in other metabolic pathways. For example, DHAP, dihydroxyacetone phosphate, is reduced to give glycerol 3-phosphate, which is used in the formation of triglyceride or fatty acid and also the triglycerides. Glycolysis interconnects with other processes such as lactate and ethanol fermentation that we discussed in the previous lecture, transamination to form alanine, pentose phosphate pathway, glycogen metabolism, etc. When there is a high demand of energy in muscles and there is insufficient supply of oxygen, anaerobic glycolysis pathway is used to generate energy. Erythrocytes derive energy from lactic acid fermentation as they are divide up mitochondria. As most of the reactions are reversible, glucose is also generated back from pyruvate by the process which is known as gluconeogenesis. Glycolysis is also very important because several physiological processes and consequent health conditions are linked with it.